Welcome to a student's guide to Brighton High. Today we'll be guiding you through the school from a student's perspective. Right now we're taking you to the basement where the gym, auditorium, and JLTC offices are located. The first stop in our student guide is a class all freshmen are required to take, gym. I think Richard wants to show us some of his basketball skills. Let's take another look at that shot. Wow, he got skills.
I didn't see that. It's good. We gotta see that.
Alright, that's enough for the basement. Let's take you upstairs to the first floor.
Now we're taking you through the first floor, where the library and cafeteria is located. Right ahead is one of the freshman math teachers. Let's have a word.
Ms. Hostage, what made you come to teach at Brighton High?
I did my student teaching here when I was a senior in college. I worked with Ms. Brown. I really loved the school environment here, and then as soon as I finished my college education, they had an opening in the math department, and I decided to come back because I liked it so much when I worked here as a student teacher.
What do you think we should do to improve Brighton High?
I think that we need to get everybody more involved, and we especially need to reach the freshmen and explain to them how important grades are, how important their classes are, and passing those classes so that they can graduate on time with all their friends.
What should the newcomers, meaning freshmen, expect from Brighton High?
They should expect a very welcoming community, a group of teachers that is more than willing to help them in any way we can, as long as they put forth some effort. They should expect a fabulous group of students to work with and to be friends with, and the more they can get involved, the better.
Thank you, Ms. Hostage.
As a teacher, what did you expect from Brighton High?
Coming to Brighton High, I knew that I could expect a lot of collaboration because I did my student teaching here. So I knew that I would have a lot of support. I definitely expected having a lot of fun with the students because I'd already met some students and they were amazing. But I also expected a lot of hard work because I knew that teaching is a hard job.
Thank you. What do you think we can do to improve Brighton High?
I think that Brighton High is a great school. I think that every school can be improved. I think it would be great if there were more activities for students to do, both during school and after school. I know that academics come first, but I think it's important to for students to be able to take art and music classes and other electives, academic electives that they might be interested in. I also think that improving the appearance of the school, both inside and out, would help, and that maybe we can form committees so that students and teachers can work together to do that.
Thank you. What do you think the freshmen should expect from Brighton High?
I think the freshmen should expect a lot of support from the upperclassmen and should expect to have teachers that are caring and work them hard and also work hard themselves. But also, freshmen should expect to work hard. Whatever middle school they came from, it doesn't matter. They're at Brighton High School now. We have high expectations. They'll have homework every night from most of their teachers, and they should expect to work hard to prepare for college.
All right, thank you, Ms. Kelly.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
School is a wonderful school community. As you all know, we're focused on preparing students for post-secondary education by providing connected and personalized learning. And incoming ninth graders, you're going to have a wonderful time here at Brighton High School. You're going to be very successful, and we're going to prepare you for college.
All right. What do you think makes Brighton High School stand out from other schools?
The great thing about Brighton High School is we have all of the resources of a large high school. We have over 1,200 students, so we have over 15 different athletic teams, more than 25 extracurricular activities. We have a wide range of courses, 5 career pathways. So you can have anything under the sun if you come to Brighton High School to help prepare you for college. But we also have small learning communities. So you're going to be part of a small team of students and teachers that work closely together for 4 years. You're never going to feel lost or overwhelmed. You're going to feel like you're part of a small family that takes care of you and wants you to be successful.
All right. In your opinion, what can students do to make Brighton High School better?
The most important thing students can do to make Brighton High School better is to be leaders. And there's a lot of different ways you can be leaders here at Brighton High School, and all of you are leaders that I'm speaking with right now. But through monitoring your own actions and being responsible, hardworking, mature, and honest, you're able to create a wonderful, positive community and climate in our school, in your classes. And those leadership qualities help to influence people around you and make sure that everybody's doing the right thing and preparing for the future.
All right.
About the school real quick.
Honey Crew, 3 and 2.
It's popping.
Discipline coordinator.
As an upcoming freshman, what can you tell about Brighton High?
It's a large building. It's atop a very high hill. There are 3 floors and a basement. The gymnasium is located in the lower left quadrant near the Fidelis side, and we have an auditorium on the St. Elizabeth side of the building. There is no swimming pool. The building has never been a jail.
What are the tardy policies?
Students are all expected to be in class and in their seats by no later than 7:40. Coming to school after 7:40 will result in a tardy mark on your attendance, which will be marked as a T. Students receiving a T are asked to stay for 1/2 hour for detention Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Students coming after 8:00 receive a 1 on the attendance sheet, which will require them to stay for a complete hour on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Students that have a recurring and repetitive problem with detention will be required to bring their parents up to attempt to alleviate the problem and the stress of tardiness.
What are the consequences of breaking the rules?
Which rules? There are many rules here at Brighton High School. If you'd like me to go over them line by line in the student code of discipline, I can do that, but that would take a lot of time.